You may not know her name, but there's a good chance you've seen music videos or movies that she's directed.
Everything in this video is real blocks of ice. So as we're shooting, everything was melting.
She's a woman making tremendous strides in her industry, something she didn't feel could happen in her hometown of Tangier, Morocco.
The images of women growing up were really, besides being like a school teacher here and there, if that, or maybe a secretary, women did not work.
This week on African Voices, music video and film director Sanaa Hamri tells her story of making it from the streets of Tangier to the studios of Hollywood.
So I would look around and I would see all these men in the cafes and on the streets, and I would think to myself, I can be just like that and do whatever I want to do. Los Angeles was very inspiring to me, especially when I moved here, because it kind of is a vacuum of great weather and a lot of opportunity in the entertainment industry. So to me, LA is a place where I can pull my brain together and think about the scenes, what I want to shoot, things like that.
Sanaa Hamri calls Los Angeles her campus. It's where the director currently lives and does most of her work.
I hear planning. Why do I hear planning?
But the place she calls home is her birthplace, the Moroccan city of Tangier. Hamri credits the city, along with her multicultural upbringing, for influencing most of the work she does today. Her mother, Blanca, a Jewish American who moved to Morocco, says the city prepared her to be successful.
She, you know, is really very, very Tangiawi girl. She loves her town. She loves her city. I feel that wherever she would be, she would do something, because she's driving her own car. It's very important for her. She don't follow leaders and watch your parking meters. That is a that's a philosophy that is still works, you know, and that's very ingrained in her DNA, shall we say.
I'm a product of a multicultural union of my father, who is and was Moroccan, and my mother, who is American. So I was able to grow in a household that had both. I very much identify as a Moroccan woman because I was born and raised there. My father's Moroccan and I went to school there, and, you know, that is home to me.
Sanaa Hamri's father is Mohamed Hamri, a popular Moroccan painter who died in 2000. His works can be found all over her mother's home in Tangier, and Sanaa keeps a few of her favorites at her house in Los Angeles.
It's a key that was done in 1978. I remember growing up and my father would not sell it because I loved this painting. And there were times when we really didn't have any money, and he was like, this is the key to all the doors in the future. And he never sold it, and I have it.
The popularity of her father's paintings didn't translate to a well-off upbringing for Sanaa. But because her mother taught at the American School of Tangier, she had opportunities others in her neighborhood didn't.
Had she had not gone and worked at this American School of Tangier, I most likely wouldn't have had a decent education. And I think that was the ticket. It's something like the memory of it for me is education was something that was a gift and that you have to take advantage of.
Sanaa was determined to take advantage of the opportunity because she wanted to move beyond the restrictions of the women around her.
The images of women growing up were really, besides being like a school teacher here and there, if that, or maybe a secretary, women did not work. You didn't see women drive. You didn't see women working like at a cafe. Like, there are a bunch of things that you see now in Morocco that's completely normal. But growing up, and this is like 80s we're talking about, there was no kind of powerful female force that was like leading the way around me. During that time, Tangier was not the safest city to be around. Over there, it was a very like darker street culture of males. So as a woman, you never felt really comfortable unless you were covered. And I didn't cover myself. So I remember walking through the streets and getting harassed constantly by men, you know, saying things or whatever it was. So I would look around and I would see all these men in the cafes and on the streets. And I would think to myself, I can be just like that and do whatever I want to do as you do. Just because I'm of a different gender, that doesn't mean I can't drive, I can't rule, I can't think, I can't create.
Hamri says her rebellious attitude was influenced by the pop culture she was exposed to at the American School of Tangier.
I was able to get and hear like the Michael Jackson songs, Madonna, and see all these people rise. And I said, wow, there's another life out there. Like, I can do that. I can be that. I can do whatever I want to do. But in my head, I was like, I have to come to the United States to do that.
When it was time for her to go to college, Hamri saw that as her chance to get to America.
The opportunity came because I got a scholarship to Sarah Lawrence College in New York. It was a big culture shock. And one thing that I loved about it was the energy. It had a similar energy to Tangier with like kind of multicultural people from all walks of life, a little shadiness, different aspects. I loved the cultures, but also one thing that I felt free. Like I felt so free that I could walk down the street and nobody bothered me. Like, that is one of those things in which I would think about all the time. I was always happy about that.
Hamri was a drama major and originally pursued acting when she graduated.
I needed a job, and I was doing auditions for, like, theater projects and all that. And I was introduced to the cinematographer, Malik Saeed, who needed an assistant at this post-production facility, just to answer phones and like run errands. And I think this story, I mean, a lot of people, especially young people, should understand that that's why when you get an opportunity, even if it's answering the phones, you better answer the phones the best way you can answer them. Like everything you do, you have to do well. And that was in my head. And there were these Avids, which are the editing machines. And I heard that you can make a lot of money cutting on these machines. So I went on the machine and I started teaching myself how to cut. And I kept doing that for a couple weeks. And then I remember Malik was shooting with Spike Lee somewhere. I remember him coming back and he found me at the machine. And I said, oh, I know how to edit. And Malik's like, well, you're not Avid certified. Like people go to school for this. And I was like, well, I taught myself and then I want to do it. And I started editing for him and then Hype Williams and Brett Ratner and all these other directors.
Hamri now found herself in the midst of some of the biggest names in the music industry. And one of those personalities would give her advice that would lead to her calling.
She's like, you need to direct. You're so much better than these old white men.